Hello party people, welcome to a new game of the day. This one is another Sicilian defense game. It was played between Fischer, the white pieces, and Bolbokan, the black pieces. It was played in Stockholm, Sweden in 1962. And okay, this is one of the lesser known games by Fischer. More on the strategic side, to put it this way, but nonetheless very impressive. Okay, let's see. You see the open Sicilian. And we see here H3. The idea is to play G4 very quick and to castle queen side. But black has very good counter chances. He plays his knight to c6. We see the idea g4. Black takes in the center, and white recaptures with his queen on d4. And black here plays e5. White goes back. Black plays e7, and here white plays g5. The idea is not so much the attack on the king side, but to dislocate here this bishop, this knight, so that you gain control over d5. The problem in these variations for black is always here this weakness on d5, and if white is able to occupy the square with his knight, then he will have a huge strategic advantage, and this is what Fischer is aiming for. So after black plays his knight to d7, white just calmly develops, and okay, as I said, the white castles long. Okay, these are our standard moves. If you play the Sicilian, this is nothing new for you. Okay, this is like the interesting position. Again, as I said, white wants to gain control over the d5 square, and the only defender of that square is d5, is the bishop on e6, and this is basically the best piece in black's game. And one rule is if you can exchange your opponent's best piece, then do it. This is what white here now does. He plays his good bishop to h3, so that he can exchange this piece here. Black has no choice. He takes, and now d5 is eternally weak. So that's why he tried his knight to b6 with the idea of covering d5. But white just took, and now we see the bishop, pardon me, the knight coming to d5. And the problem is that now you have a classic situation. This is exactly what you do not want, this kind of situation, if you play the Sicilian. We have a very strong knight on d5. And the counterpart here, the bishop on e7, is of no good use. He has no good squares. And okay, now the problem is okay, you have the strategic advantage. How do you convert it into something tangible? And okay, Fischer plays here the best moves. Basically, in those kind of oppositions, you want to, one idea is to infiltrate your opponent's position. One idea is to get your pieces as close to the king as possible, okay, and to restrict your opponent's moves. So basically Fischer is now switching back and forth between those ideas. And okay, just notice that here you cannot take here with the idea of then playing the queen to d6 and winning a pawn, because then black just plays rook to d8 and winning, because you have a weak back rank. So you always have to be very careful. Okay. Okay, now here black just wants to connect his rooks. White plays a very strong move. He plays his queen to f5. You cannot capture here, because then white just takes here with check, and you lose a piece. So he protects his queen, and black now attacks on the weak squares. Again, as I said times and times before, if your opponent has a weakness, try to create another weakness, so that you can attack more than one weakness, because most of the times you can only defend one weakness, and if your opponent attacks two weaknesses, you have a problem. So black now switched his focus to the queen side, attacking here those weak pawns. And okay, black defended, and now white goes back. Basically, here he owns now the C line. Black tries to gain some luft for his king, and to get the queen out of this good from this good square here on f5. Pardon me, he played his king to g4, his queen to g4. Black goes back. Now trying to get an exchange of the queens. Of course, black doesn't want it. White doesn't want it. He has the advantage. And now we see another motif. We see the penetration motif. White just comes in into black's position. And okay, now as you can see, black already has no squares for his pieces. And white just makes it worse for black. And now look at this position. You have total infiltration of black's position. Black is basically on the back rank, and this makes it even more grotesque looking. You have all black's pieces here basically in this area, and I mean, it doesn't take a genius to see that this is completely lost and horrible. So basically this is like stage 3. You have converted your strategic advantage to a very tangible advantage. You have complete control over the position, and black is crept in. White here makes luft because he doesn't want to get into some back rank complications. And okay, I mean, here black basically has no moves. He wants to try to get some pieces out so that he can somehow liberate his position. But okay, yeah, as you can see, it's of no good. This is a weakness, and white attacks this. Since this king is extremely weak, in this kind of position now, it's all about opening up lines to the king. Because again, his position is weak, this one is strong. All of your pieces are hovering around the black king. So basically now it's time to open up lines and attacking the king. Black tries this move. He doesn't want to open up the position, and white doesn't care. This is a very beautiful move, because you cannot take. If you try to take, then basically this is complete over. Yeah, you just drag the king out in the open. And I mean, here basically every move wins. You can play f5 and capturing here, or rook to h5, and as soon as the queen leaves, then you pick up here the bishop, and you still have a raging attack. So you cannot really play f4, bishop taking on f4. So white, black here played the best move, and he took on g6. But look at his position now; it's even worse. And okay, white now plays the killer move, the strongest move in the position. he places queen to b3, threatening here the rediscovered attack. And okay, this is basically hopeless, and out of desperation, black tries rook to f4. We see a discovered check. And okay, black resigned. But this would have been the continuation. You just take, you come in with the queen, and you go for a checkmate. Yeah, this was a very beautiful game by Fischer. I mean, this is like the problem when you or when weaker players play against stronger players. Weaker players, they know their opening, and they can play it, but they don't grasp the deeper strategic ideas. And as soon as a strong player has this strategic advantage, like in this position, Fischer, he just, I mean, this is like, this piece is winning the whole game. There's nothing basically that you can do already. White has a big advantage. I would advise you to study how here White switches between different strategies to win. This is a lot of this is a problem that a lot of amateurs have. Even if they have a good position, they don't know the strategic ideas. But if you know a lot of strategic ideas, you can always try them out. We have like here the attack of weaknesses, the infiltration. Pardon me, the infiltration. Yeah, then you try to gain more space and try to restrict your opponent's space, and so you can just switch around those theorems. And then at the end of the day, you go for the king attack. You open up lines, you open the position as much as you can. Even if it means to sacrifice material, you just go for the king. And okay, another beautiful game by Fischer. Another beautiful Sicilian defense game that I strongly recommend you to study. Again, this was Fischer against Volbochan, Stockholm 1962. Thanks, bye.